These laser collimation tools are super popular for aligning the optics on your reflector telescope. But did you know that a lot of these laser collimation tools need alignment themselves? And in this video, I'm going to show you my cheap and easy way to collimate the laser collimators using nothing more than a piece of wood, a 2-inch hole saw, and a 2-inch to 1¼-inch eyepiece adapter. Let's go ahead and get started. Most of these laser collimation tools are very similar. I've been using this svbony one for a couple of years now. This basic setup will run you about $25, and this one comes with a 2-inch to 1¼-inch adapter, just in case you don't already have one. And by the way, there is a very convenient link for this item down in the description box below. Anyway, this top knob section has detents in it, and they go from 0 all the way around to 7. 0 means off, and 1 through 7 means it gets brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter. 7 is pretty darn bright, but then it goes back to 0. I learned early on that these laser alignment tools often need aligning themselves so that the laser goes straight down the middle of this cylindrical tube. I found out about this accidentally because when I inserted this into the telescope focuser tube and then I spun this around, the resulting laser traced out a circle on the primary mirror instead of a single point. And I thought, well, that's not good. As the name implies, a laser collimator is indeed a laser. Please use extreme caution because a laser can cause permanent blindness. And always know where the laser is pointing because not even goggles like these provide any protection. And when the laser collimator is inserted into the telescope, first wave your hand in front of the open telescope to check if the reflected laser is completely missing the secondary mirror, then shooting out the front of the telescope. The last thing you want to do is look down the end of a telescope and have the reflected laser hit you right. Be careful and go slow, and back to the video. Okay, so if you've watched this far, then you've probably already discovered that your laser alignment tool has a problem and needs collimated. Well, let me show you how to fix yours quickly and cheaply. Now for step one, we're going to need a piece of wood that will clamp to the end of a table, and you want it to be at least 3/8 inch thick because you want it to have some rigidity to it, okay? So let's go ahead and drill a 2-inch hole through here. I had to use the 2-inch to 1¼-inch adapter because, strangely enough, I did not have an 1¼-inch hole saw, but I did have a 2-inch hole saw. So I put the 2-inch adapter in the hole like that and dropped that in, and then I clamped it on the end of the table like so. It's pretty rigid. Step two is to make sure that you have a tight fit between the laser collimator and the 2-inch to 1¼-inch adapter. Now, in this case, it's actually pretty tight, but let's say yours is not. For example, oddly enough, in the one that came with the laser collimator, it's actually quite loose. So I'm going to show you a quick way to take up some of that slop that's in there. All it takes is a piece of painter's tape. All right. Just wrap this around the barrel. And we're going to have it overlap just a little bit, like that. And we're going to use a trick that I learned from wallpaper people. Actually, I learned this by watching This Old House. So you just cut through the overlap, peel that part off, and then flip this little bit up. There's a little bit there that just comes off. And then when you lay that down, you have a perfect seam. And when it goes in here, it's nice and snug. Look at that. For the alignments that we're gonna do, we're gonna need 4 marks that represent basically 0, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock. And that's easily done with painter's tape. This does not have to be exact at all. We're just gonna wrap another band all the way around, like this. Again, it doesn't have to be exact. And I'm just going to put some lines on here, okay? So this will be 12 o'clock. We'll call this 3 o'clock,
6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock. This is going to come in real handy. Now we're going to take a piece of paper and a weight and put it down on the ground. And turn the laser on. It doesn't have to be very bright. I'm just going to put it on 2. That's actually plenty bright.
We'll mark it.
And spin at 90 degrees. Another 90 degrees. Another 90 degrees.
All right, so ideally we're going to adjust the laser collimator so that these points are no longer outlying like that. They'll be somewhere right about there, right in the middle.
All right, now for the fun part. Let's talk about how we actually do the alignment on this. These laser collimators have 3 set screws, one there, and one there. In a way, they work like the collimation systems in the
viewfinders.
You have to carefully adjust these set screws so that the laser shoots straight down the middle of this cylinder. If you look at yours and perhaps you only see 2 of the set screws, well, that probably means that this warning label is covering one. So you know, this will probably void your warranty, but if you want to get to that set screw, you may have to move this label. Keep the label with it, just move it a little bit to the side. Another side note is the manufacturers like to put a glob of either glue or silicone in there, and in my case, I actually had to dig it out with an X-Acto knife. So go ahead and remove the glue that's covering the set screws.
And make sure you can get the adjustment wrench down in there. Mine is a 2mm Allen wrench.
The collimation of this is actually going to probably take more time than the collimation of your telescope. This is a bit of a tedious process. And to help you, I'm going to just share some of the tips that I have. Let's mark these screws. I'm going to mark them as just 1, 2, and 3, like that. So my advice is to pick any set, for example, 1 and 2, or 2 and 3, etc., and only adjust those for a while. So make small adjustments, loosen one, tighten the other one, put it back in the holder, and spin it around again, and see if the circle of points got tighter and tighter. If it got bigger, then obviously that was not it. You can move those 2 back, and then try moving on to another set of screws. But just try to work with 2 at a time to figure out which screws cause the laser to move in what direction. Because essentially there are 3 sets, and that will give you a clue as to which sets control which direction the laser is going to move. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to loosen number 1 a little bit, maybe an 1/8 of a turn, and I'll tighten number 2. I'll put it in here and see what that does. Now, if you wanted, you could actually put this in the jig and adjust the screws while it's in there. That would probably be a good way to do this, but always remember to adjust just the 2 screws at a time. All right, so let's just adjust these 2 screws while it's in here. I'm going to loosen this one a little bit, tighten this one a little bit, and let's see how the laser is looking down on the paper. Okay, in this case, that was really all the adjustment we needed. But in your case, you may need to adjust all 3 screws. So this particular jig that we've been using is about 1 meter from the floor. About the best that I can hope for is for those dots to fall within a grouping that's about 1/4 inch in diameter, if I were to draw a circle around it. 1/8 of an inch would be pretty amazing, to be honest. But one of the questions I get is, how do I make it even more accurate? Well, it's pretty easy. All you have to do is increase this height and go much, much higher. For example, mount this on top of a stepladder instead. And I've even seen people take this and lay it on its side or at an angle and project it,
you know, across their garage for extreme accuracy. But remember, it doesn't have to be perfect. And in fact, the center mark circle on your mirrors is typically about 3/8 of an inch to even a half of an inch, depending on which ones you have. And if you know of a different way to align your laser collimator, please tell me about it down in the comment section below. Clear skies, everybody.